Hi everyone, I'm Mike, and today I'm going to show you how to fix the DMARC fail error. DMARC is an email authentication process designed to help combat spam and spoof messages. Therefore, if you're seeing the DMARC fail notification, it means that this layer of the security check wasn't successful. Fortunately, there are steps you can take to remedy this problem. In this video, we'll walk you through three methods you can use to resolve it. But before we get started, I want to let you know that there'll be links to more resources in the video's description below. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. Now, how to know if your email failed DMARC. There are two main ways that you can check to see whether your email failed DMARC. Email headers are the pieces of information that are added to an email when it's sent. They include things like sender's IP address, the date and time the email was sent, and other information. Using Gmail as an example, to view the email headers, you can click on the three vertical dots next to reply in the top right corner of an email. Then select Show Original. In the window that opens, you can view information about the original message, including whether it was a DMARC pass or fail. In this example, the email authentication passed. However, if you see DMARC authentication results fail, this means that the email failed the authentication process. If you're using Outlook, you can view the headers by clicking on the View Message Details in the top right corner of an email. Again, scroll to the bottom to see if there's an authentication fail message. Now that you understand a little more about what a DMARC failure is and what can cause it, let's explore the solutions. Here are three methods for fixing a DMARC fail error. It's important to set up SPF and DKIM before DMARC to avoid email delivery issues. Unless you specify a DKIM signature for your domain, your email service provider will typically assign a default one to outgoing emails, such as this. This means your emails won't match the domain in your emails from headers. To ensure that your DKIM and SPF records properly align with the entries of your DNS provider, you can add the following text records to your DNS settings. And once you've added these records, you can then set up DMARC by adding the following text record to your DNS settings. You'll want to replace example.com with your actual domain name. Again, you can check with your DNS provider to learn where to find and edit these records. If you use Kinsta DNS, you can add DNS records through your My Kinsta dashboard. Our custom-built control panel lets you access a wide range of features and solutions for managing and troubleshooting issues, including our application performance monitoring tool. After selecting your site, you can click on the Kinsta DNS menu item. Here, you can search for a text record in the type column. If you need to add an SPF text record, you can do so by using mail channels. Note that we don't have separate records for DKIM, just CNAME text records. There are three possible actions that result from an email failing DMARC: reject, quarantine, or none. If the policy record is changed to none, the email will still be delivered to the recipient's inbox even if it fails DMARC. In the other two cases, it will either end up in the recipient's spam folder or bounce back to you. Therefore, the next solution would be to modify your DMARC policy record to P equals none. You can do this by adding the following text record to your DNS settings. Again, remember to replace the placeholder URL with your domain name. It's worth noting that none policy isn't the most secure option, so you may only want to consider using it as a temporary solution. If you send marketing and transactional emails using a third-party service provider, such as MailChimp, you'll have to edit your DNS records to permit the provider to send emails from your domain. Pointing your DNS entries to your DNS provider will authenticate and authorize the specified servers. To get started, you'll need to verify your domain. The authentication can also only be successful with a third party if the domain belongs to you or your business, rather than a public service such as Google. Once you locate your domain's records, you can copy and paste that information from MailChimp or whatever provider you're using to your domain's CNAME records. Check with your email software or service provider for detailed guidance, as the information you'll need and specific instructions may differ. You can access your domain records by logging into your domain registrar's control panel. This may be cPanel or Plesk. If you're a Kinsta user, you can access your My Kinsta dashboard and then navigate to Kinsta DNS. Once you have this information, you can return to MailChimp and follow its instructions for adding CNAME records and authenticating your domain. After the email service provider confirms that the records are accurate, you should receive a success or confirmation email. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. We offer 2 months free with any annual plan, a 30-day money-back guarantee, and unlimited free basic migrations from any host. Head over to kinsta.com/plans to get started, and thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.